What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another reaction video, where today we are actually going to be looking at the origins of Kylo Ren's helmet has finally been revealed. Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker. The stupendous wave. I have gone out of my way to completely ignore any spoilers pertaining to The Rise of Skywalker, and the fact that this actually has The Rise of Skywalker in it kind of makes me concerned. But I'm taking a leap of faith. So anyway, let's get into it.
For years now, many of us have speculated the true origins of Kylo Ren's mask. We know the reasoning behind why Kylo Ren ultimately constructed his mask, but we don't know the details of how he got it, until today. We know that Kylo Ren constructed this helmet in essence of his grandfather Darth Vader, Lord of the Sith, in an effort that Kylo Ren could one day live up to the massive lineage of his grandfather Darth Vader. We also know that Ben Solo donned the mask to hide his own inner light and conflicted nature from his enemies and family, most notably Leia and Han Solo. But now, we know that wearing the mask was more a part of initiation of the Knights of Ren than we had previously assumed, and this could actually pose a major connection between the Knights of Ren and the dark side organization known as the Acolytes of the Beyond in Star Wars Aftermath. In the official Ultimate Guidebook for the Rise of Skywalker, we learn a lot about the origins of Kylo Ren's mask, as well as why and how he constructed the mask, and the relationship that it has with the Knights of Ren, and essentially how Kylo Ren became the master of the Knights of Ren. Here's what the quote says. Kylo Ren's helmet is designed in the style of the Knights of Ren. It is also reminiscent of the infamous mask that his grandfather Darth Vader wore, connecting Kylo Ren to the dark side and his family heritage. The helmet conceals his former identity as Ben Solo, also obscured by the helmet's vocoder, which makes his voice sound more threatening, and also serves to intimidate both his enemies and his subordinates in the First Order. Beyond this, and the protection it affords, the helmet has no special functions. So again, according to this, we learn a few things about the origins of Kylo Ren's mask. We learn that Kylo Ren constructed the mask after the group of the Knights of Ren, not the other way around as many people originally assumed, with many people thinking that the Knights of Ren constructed their own masks to be reminiscent of that of Kylo Ren, and not the other way around. We also know, according to this, that the Knights of Ren were apparently around before Kylo Ren fell to the dark side of the Force, as it makes it clear that Kylo Ren ventured to the Knights of Ren and as a sort of initiation created his mask, a mask reminiscent of that of Darth Vader, again telling us that the Knights of Ren were around before Ben Solo's fall and corruption by Snoke. So now, while it is possible for a lot of Luke's fallen Jedi students to eventually become the Knights of Ren, we know that the group was around before this, and the group likely worshipped the Sith and Darksiders. Unfortunately, a lot of the greater details on how Kylo Ren came to know and become leaders of the Knights of Ren is unknown, but that will be covered in the Kylo Ren miniseries, which is coming out this December. What we do know now is, according to the official guidebook, Kylo Ren created his helmet to be reminiscent of the Knights of Ren, not the other way around as many people assume. And very importantly, as I've stated several times now, the Knights of Ren were actually around before Kylo Ren became Kylo Ren. In the Star Wars Aftermath novels, the Acolytes of the Beyond, which is basically a dark side cult that worships the Sith, also holds a great significance to masks, and it was a part of their order basically to construct their own masks or wear masks of ancient Sith lords, which would then allow them to become a part of this organization, meaning that right now it's very, very possible that the Acolytes of the Beyond were a very early version of the Knights of Ren. If this is true though, we'll just have to wait until December. But what are your guys' thoughts on this and the fact that Kylo?
Well, that's the end of this video. If you did enjoy it, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to my channel, turn on notifications, also subscribe to this stupendous wave. And I think that this video was fairly interesting. I don't really enjoy Kylo Ren's mask a whole lot. The reconstruction of his mask with the red lines and everything looks a lot better than how it did in both The Force Awakens and Last Jedi. But with that being said, please leave a like, subscribe, turn on notifications like I've said before, and, well, see you guys next time.